Okay, so I'm just doing a bit more on my painting and come to the last bit of brickwork, so I thought I'd do a quick video just to give you an idea of how I do it. I use these four colours, burnt umber, burnt sienna, sap green, Payne's grey and fallow green mixed, so it gives you kind of a shady colour but not as stark as Payne's grey on its own. It gives it a little bit more sort of age, I think. I've marked off the areas that I don't want to get paint on, so I'll show you how I do it. Put a bit of the dark colour under the window ledge because it's going to be a shaded place, and then I kind of just want to get my other colours just kind of mixed up. Leave a little bit at the bottom and then go to the green, and you can kind of touch that in for a bit of weathering, just touch it in different areas, and then you have to be a bit forgiving because I'm doing this on my own, which isn't ideal, and I'm usually sitting down, so I'm actually standing up to do this. But bold, you've got to be bold. Now, when you've got your main colours in, stand back and have a look, a bit brown, and you've got some shadow. Area under there. That's it. Touch that in again. A bit of shadow. Looks a mess, doesn't it? A bit more green and just touch that in. And a bit more. It's okay, that's all masked. Just keep touching it in. I mean, I'll get the hairdryer on that and show you what it's like. Right, okay, so that's dry, so you can see it looks very dark. It looks aged, which is what we want. It doesn't look very dark, but this next stage should start to bring that out a little bit. I'm holding the phone and doing this, and I don't want to destroy the painting. So I'll show you a little bit, and then I'll show you what it looks like when I've done all of it again. So I use a white gel pen.
I love this opening. She says, "I'm 73. What's your grandma doing tonight?" Smooth.
To pick out my
chase the sun with Tui to over 40 destinations.
Explore the lines in between the bridges of Jamaica,
sip margaritas in Mexico,
or see the
wonders of Asia.
Quite uniform, but it doesn't really matter because it's an old building, and we don't really want
state-of-the-art Dreamliner planes.
Perfect.
Tui, we cross the T's, dot the I's, and put you in the middle.
So I'll get a bit more done and I'll come back and show you.
Okay, so I've gone in with the white gel pen and picked out all the gaps in between the brick. Tried to keep the vertical as I can, really, because otherwise your wall looks a bit wonky, but that's not such a bad thing on a painting like this. I've removed the masking tape and I've just added a slight bit of shadow just to give it a bit of pop. And then if we zoom out onto the rest of the painting, as you can see, that's pretty much how a lot of people are going to view it. I think it looks alright. So give it a try. Be interested to see how you get on. Happy painting.